Hi everyone. One of the most important things that you need to pay careful attention while using ArcGIS is how to organize your labs and where to save your data. First of all, BW provides you an H drive, which is in this PC. You can find your H drive, which starts with the first letter of your first name and your followed by your last name. You can save your data, read and write your data here, but as you can see, it has only 2 GB capacity and fills up very fast. But H drive is important because it's in the VDI, so you can access to H drive from outside of campus. Just connect to your VDI, as we talked about before, and have access to your H drive. So the way that I suggest you to organize your data is to first create a new folder. So I go inside of H drive and I create a new folder with the name of GIS_labs. Okay. So you should never use space while naming a folder. So it's not GIS space lab, it's GIS_lab. I could name it labs or GIS, but GIS_labs is good. So because if you use a space, sometimes it causes big problems. Okay, you cannot read your data and other problems happening when you use a space while naming your folders. You should also never use a space for naming the files, okay, in the GIS directory. So go inside of this folder and create some other subfolders, such as lab 1. Again, I do not use a space, okay. Another one, lab 2. Lab 3, lab 4. I think you got the idea, until lab 10. Okay, so for lab 1, so for instance this week we have lab 1, you have to, if there is something that you need to download, only download your data and save your data in lab 1 folder. And if you create some maps, the output of your lab 1, always save them in lab 1 folder. Okay, so for the next week we have lab 2. Go save everything in lab 2, your maps, your data, and then save everything and put everything in lab 2, and so forth. Okay, that's how you can have an organized structure for your labs for the entire semester. Again, never use a space in naming folder, and never use a space in naming GIS files. Another way to save your, another place to save your data is using OneDrive. OneDrive is a place in cloud that you can save your documents or data. You can have access your data from everywhere. It's like VDI. So just type, open your browser and type onedrive.com. Onedrive.com or onedrive.live.com. So OneDrive has very interesting features. First of all, it's a very safe place to store your data. So we can see that it's a very safe place. You can store your data. It also allows you to share your data from OneDrive with other people, and also you can sync OneDrive to your device, so then you can have offline access. It's a very interesting feature, and some other features too. Share your data or access file from any device. So how you can have access to OneDrive? You can click on sign in here, and then you need to put your email, BW email address here. It also may require you to put your password and then click sign in. So here is the environment of OneDrive. So you can create a new folder, such as what we did in the H drive. Right click new folder with the name of GIS. Again, I do not use space, GIS underscore labs, create. Go inside of the folder and create some new subfolders. Again, new folder lab 1, new folder lab 2, and so forth, so on. Okay, we can also upload your data in OneDrive. For example, if I want to upload the data, put the data into lab 1, such as this PDF file, I can just drag files here. And you can see that it will be added to your OneDrive. You can also drag a folder, such as this one, GIS Labs. You know that it's a folder. So you can drag the folder and put it in your OneDrive. Okay, again, never use a space if you want to save your GIS data for your labs, for naming the labs or folders. So another, the last way, another way to save your data is to have a thumb drive with at least 2 GB capacity, such as this one, USB drive. And then again, save your data in the structure that I told you. Never use a space and put all of your labs here and save the data in lab 1 when we have lab 1, results in lab 1, and so forth, so on. So it's a good idea to back up your data and save them in multiple places in an organized way. So that's how we can save our data in an organized way and in multiple places.